This is the Secretary of Agriculture. This is not, you know, Brian Tokar, Luddite, recognized Luddite in the world. It is the Secretary of Agriculture. And I have a series of quotes like this from people who, you don't need to get it from me. If you look at the people who were driving this, you'll realize there's a much deeper agenda than this. Now, I recognize I have only 5 more minutes. In those 5 more minutes, I want to tell you that the reason why you have very few people here now is because this campaign was successful, but because they are now being lured into a new song. From the same people who brought you, we're going to feed the world and deliver nothing. From the same people who brought you, we're going to have Silicon Valley or biotech pitch or biotech fjord or whatever it is that they've been selling around the world and produce nothing. Those same people are now here in Boston selling you new stories. You will not hear that they're going to feed the world. They are here to save the world from ourselves, from global warming, from climate change, from the rising seas and all the things that are happening. It's not that it's not happening, but I feel that there is a massive drive of predatory behavior that attacks hope and that attacks fear, that uses fear and preys on our hope that we can do something and that we have to do something fast, and says, you know, stop any questioning, don't look at it, just trust us again, give us more time, give us more money, we'll solve the global warming problem. Back at home in California, and I just landed here this morning, so I feel very foreign here at this point, but back at home in California, we're fighting a massive, massive onslaught by British Petroleum, Exxon, and all the energy and oil companies driving in, trying to buy, in my case, Berkeley with $500 million to establish what's called a bioenergy institute. The only thing they're doing is they're repackaging the rotten dream, the nightmare that we all had, and saying, we are going to do it this time. You will not hear the word GMO. You will not hear the term genetic engineering. The word that is being used now is synthetic biology. And what they say there is, the reason why GMOs didn't work is because they got it wrong, because those people who were trying to do it were dealing with dirty code encoded into those DNA circuits. They don't talk about organisms, they talk about DNA circuits. And those DNA circuits have to be reprogrammed with clean code. I mean, what is this thing? You're working with a machine that was created billions of years ago, and then there's all this dirtiness of code coming in over evolutionary time. It's just impossible to work with that. Now we're going to start from scratch. Now it's in the hands of the engineers. They took it away from the hands of the very few biologists who were behind this. Most of the biologists that I respect understand that this is craziness. But now it is in the hands of engineers. It's in the hands of physicists who once again are trying this idea that you can reduce life and living things to particles, that you can think of them as if they were machines, and that especially you can make money out of them through patent policies, enforcement of patent policies throughout the world, and the taxing of people for the use, so-called use, of those so-called technologies, DNA circuits and so on. So I invite you to become engaged, to recognize that a new stage has been entered in our time, and that the incredible success of the past will have to be restructured and rethought in a new way. Why is this so important to recognize? Because, as I said before, where before a little bit of traction could be had from the tension between Republican and Democrat, or between left and right, or between progressive and conservative, and so on, all those lines of polarization have disappeared in this time around. So we have to rethink who we are. We have to rethink what it is that we want. And certainly what was true in 1999 and will be true again, and I think is true in this room again, we need to recover our imagination of what world we want. And we need to make sure that we're not presented with solutions where all we get to say is, I'm with you, or I'm out of job, or I'm out on the street. We need to recover the imagination of what we want, what kind of world we want, and to recognize that the idea of working with living things as DNA circuits and machines is not going to work. I'm very open for further comments, but I think my time is up. Thank you very much.